I've got my lathe tools. I've got blocks to turn. I think I need to build a lathe. Hey y'all, I'm James Wright and welcome to my shop. So I got all my lathe tools and I've picked out what I want to do, but now I need a lathe in order to turn on them. So we're gonna be working on this today. Now, last week I put out the video on cutting out all the stock out of a single 2x12, 12 foot long, and that was a lot of fun. Now we're gonna actually start in on the joinery. I'm doing mortise and tenon through the uprights in the stretchers and actually getting this assembly. You can kind of see the idea of how this is gonna come out. Here is the headstock, and then there will be a tailstock that moves in here. And then there'll be this arm up here with a rope that comes down around it, and it's basically a spring pole lathe with a treadle pedal down here. I'm going to be putting tusk tenons in here in the future, but today we're just gonna be looking at the mortise and tenon joinery on this and give a little bit more information and detail on that. So let's jump into the project. I'm gonna start by laying out the tenons on these three stretchers. All three are basically the exact same with the same tenon on both ends of all three, so six tenons total, if that makes sense. I'm gonna use this mortising gauge to mark out both sides of the tenon. I'm cutting the cheeks on the edges as opposed to on the sides of the board, so the mortising gauge makes a fairly easy way of flipping it over and marking on all three sides that need to be cut. Making sure I keep the reference on the same side of the board so that there's the same distance in from either side, if that makes sense. Next, I'm gonna go and cut off the cheeks of the tenons. I started by using a panel saw and cutting down to the depth I needed. After that has been cut down, then I can come in with a cross-cut saw and cut out the shoulder. And so basically removing this small piece creates the cheek and shoulder of the tenon. After doing this for a little while, I thought, you know, I'm going to try switching over to the Japanese tools and learn them on that, because the pine is actually a great tool for that. They work very efficiently in softwoods as opposed to hardwoods, at least in my experience. So with this Ryoba, I can easily cut down the cheek, and you can see how I started it with one hand and was got a little closer to it so I could eyeball it, then stood back and held the handle with both hands. And it actually went fairly quickly all the way down. The nice thing about the Ryoba is that with one saw I can flip it over and then use the cross-cutting teeth to then cut down the shoulders on the tenon as well. All told, it went very well. And I think for pine joinery, I'm going to be grabbing this a lot more often now that I'm getting used to it. And it cuts very nicely, and one of the nice things about it is that it will leave a smoother surface, which makes me very happy. If you want to see my videos, I have videos on Japanese saws as well. Now, the next thing I need to do is actually cut the other tenon on the other end of the board. And so rather than cutting them all at one time, the important thing is that the measurement from the shoulder on one to the shoulder on the other, it needs to be the same distance on all three boards. I don't care how long the tenon actually is off of the shoulder. The only thing I really care about is the distance from shoulder to shoulder. Once I have that marked out, then I can flip the board over and use the pre-existing tenon to mark off what I want to cut off. That way I'm not having to lay out everything again with the saw. And then go back to town. I can just chop them all up and make some dust. Just having fun in the shop. Now we can work on the sides. This is what the tenons will be going into. I need to cut six mortises for those to go into, so I can start laying them out. And I'm actually going to be just laying them out on the one side, so on the shorter side. This will be the headstock of the lathe in the end. And so I'm laying out where they will be placed. Two stretchers up top that the tailstock slides on, and one stretcher at the bottom to separate the bottom. Once I have those all laid out, I can come in with the brace and bit and remove most of the material. Boring out the material, especially in pine, is so much faster. In oak, sometimes I'll go back and forth, but with pine, you just can't beat the speed of a brace and bit hogging out material. Once that's been done, I can flip it over and start chopping out. Now, I had planned on holding this down with a hold fast, but I found that just with how fast it's going through the pine, I really don't need anything to hold it down. I can just chop out. I'm staying away from my lines. I have exact lines laid out. I brought the tenon over and marked off the tenon. Sorry, I don't have a video of that. But that lets me know exactly where I need to cut. I'm going to stay away from those lines as long as possible and slowly work my way back to them. And once I'm certain about where I'm at, then I can chop all the way to the line. I'm going to chop down about 3/4 of the way and then flip the board over so that I don't blow out the other side. And once I'm down about 3/4 of the way, that then only leaves that last quarter to go from the other side, making it very easy to just come back in and clean out the other side. And some last minute pairing to make sure it fits. And that's a mortise. Pretty straightforward. Doesn't have to be terribly clean. And yes, I could have made it a little cleaner, but I don't need to. I want the fit on this to be a little bit on the loose side. I want it to easily slide in and out because I do want this to be a tear down material, so it should be able to slide in and out fairly easily. I can put all three stretchers into one side, and you can see how easily they end up sliding in and out of the joint. Then once that's in, we can put the other side in and flip it over. And voila, you have the structure to a lathe. The two at the top that are separated by about 2.5 inches, those will end up being the two rails that the tailstock will then slide along. And here you can get your first look at what it will basically end up looking like. There you have it. I'm really liking how this is coming out. I'm looking forward to actually turning on this. I'm hoping to have it done in time to do Christmas presents. I think I have about another 3 weeks work on this and we'll have a functioning lathe here. Next week, I'm gonna probably be doing the tusked tenons on the end of this, possibly putting the feet on the bottom. I haven't decided which I wanna do or what I'm gonna be doing. Then later on, I'm gonna be building the tailstock, putting in the turning heads, the tool rest, and well, the pedals, the stick, and the arm is a pretty quick one. And then there'll be a spring coming on here. So about another 3 or 4 episodes, and we're gonna be having fun with this. If you do wanna see the tools that I have purchased, I'll leave a link to those down below. I'm going to be doing several videos with traditional tools as well as carbide tools, and I even have a small pin turning set, and I'm going to do a few other things in that and showing how you can use a spring pole lathe and a fairly cheap lightweight system and do just about anything turning. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, feel free to let me know in the comments below or hit like over here. I do want to say thank you to the patrons on Patreon. You guys are the reason why I can keep putting out content like this. If you'd like to help out with Patreon or find out more, you can do that right down there. And until next time, have a wonderful day.